Yes, so good evening, dear writers, poets, and all the lovely people who've tuned into the Neelam Saxena page on FB Live. My name is Purna, and I shall be your host for the 34th International Poetry Meet live from Mumbai, connecting poets all across the globe and inviting them to render their beautiful creations. We have Neelam Saxena ma'am herself from Mumbai, India, who will be taking the admin responsibilities of this event. I would like to first of all introduce all the eminent poets with a warm welcome. We start with Dr. Meenakshi Mohan from USA. Dr. Meenakshi Mohan is an academic writer, poet, and an artist. She has published widely. Her most recent books are Rebirth of the Demon and Tapestry of Women in Indian Mythology. She is on the editorial board for Inquiry in Education, a peer-reviewed journal of National Lewis University, Chicago. She is also one of the advisory editor for Confluence UK. Meenakshi has received the Sethu Bilingual Journal Award of Excellence and the Panorama International Writers Capital Foundation Award. She also recently reviewed the Literoma Laureate Lifetime Achievement Award, and her new book is also being coming up shortly. Let's give a warm round of applause to Meenakshi ma'am. Also, from USA, we have Concetta Pipia. Concetta is the founder of the Aspiring Writers Society, a writing group. She is the co-editor of its anthology, Seasons of Change, Reflecting Today, Dreaming Tomorrow. Her writing embraces both fiction and non-fiction poetry and prose. Her work has been published in numerous international anthologies, including Love and Longing, Angst, Suffolk Country Poetry Review. Her work also appears in literary magazines, including The Raven's Perch, Adding Breath to Words, The Wise Owls, and she also attended the Parsons School of Design, the Touro University School of Law, and the University of Phoenix. Thank you so much for joining us, Concetta ma'am.
I'm honored. Thank you.
I would now like to welcome Sunil Sharma, sir, from Canada. Sunil Sharma calls himself a humble word worshipper, a catcher of elusive sounds, meanings, and images. He has published 27 creative and critical books, joint and solo. A winner of, amongst others, the Golden Globe Award 2023 and MISM Award for Excellence for the novel Minotaur. His poems were included in the prestigious UN project Happiness, the Delight Tree, an anthology of contemporary international poetry 2015. He is also the editor of the monthly Sethu Journal in English. Dear sir, it's a pleasure to have you on board. And the next eminent poet that I would like to introduce is our very own Neelam Saxena ma'am. She actually needs no introduction, but yes, she has authored six novels and nine short story collections, 43 poetry collections, and 15 children's books. She holds three records with the Limca Book of Records. She has received the Sohanlal Dwivedi Puraskar for Children's Literature by Maharashtra State Hindi Sahitya Academy for the year 2018, Premchand Award by the Ministry of Railways, Rabindranath Tagore International Poetry Award, Freedom Award by Radio City for lyrics, Award by American Embassy given by Gulzar Saab, Renault Lifetime Achievement Award, etc. She was listed in Forbes as one amongst the 78 most popular authors in the country in 2014. She will also be our event facilitator. Always a pleasure to have you with us, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining. And now I would like to welcome Garima Sudhan, ma'am, all the way from Bahrain. Garima Sudhan is a teacher by profession, lives in Bahrain. She is an alumnus of Notre Dame Academy and JD Women's College, Patna. Garima Sugan has inherited her passion for poetry from her father, Mr. Gurpal Singh Sugan. A bilingual poet, she writes both in English and Hindi. Her first Hindi poetry book, Sulje Ansulje Jazbaat, was published in the year 2020. Her poems are published in more than 25 international anthologies. She has participated and she has won awards in various poetry competitions. Thank you so much, Garima ma'am, for joining. So let us give all the wonderful poets a huge round of applause. Ma'am, I'm not able to hear you. Ma'am, did you say something?
Just wait for a second and let me introduce our beautiful host for the day. Poorna Parekh is a self-taught poetess and has completed her MBA from Nirma University. She is currently working as an associate in corporate communications at Zydus Healthcare Limited, Goregaon, Mumbai. She finds joy in learning Hindustani singing and Kathak dance, but finds solace in poetry writing. Poetry writing is as indispensable for her soul as breathing. She believes in writing for a cause, and both her published anthologies, Sketches of My Mind, 2013, and A Poetic Devil's Workshop, 2015, are tiny steps towards philanthropy. Welcome, Poorna.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for introducing me. So sweet of you. And we have Rupa Rao, ma'am, also joining from New Jersey. Nivedita, ma'am, as well. Thank you so much for joining us, and thank you for that beautiful compliment, Neelam ma'am. You always my boat. So with this, if everyone is ready, we begin our first round. And for the first round, I would like to invite Sunil Joshi sir to recite his poem, An Immigrant Dreams, based on the lives of the millions of people who dream of settling down in Canada. Over to you, Sunil sir, waiting for you to recite your poem.
Thank you very much. This is Sunil Sharma, not Sunil Joshi, by the way.
I'm so sorry, ma'am. Sir, I was... Sunil Sharma, sir.
No problem, because Mr. Sunil Joshi should not feel insulted.
Sunil Joshi is anyway, a wonderful poet. As yes, well, yeah. But yeah, I'll call you Sunil sir, okay?
Yeah, no problem. Yeah. You can call me Sunil. Well, big thanks first of all to the wonderful hosts, Neelam Saxena madam, whom we all admire, we respect, and the young moderator Poorna Parekh, from whom I'm very sure I can learn a lot, finding solace in poetry like Neelam madam and others of the ilk, very, very important in today's commodified culture. Again, thank you, Neelam Saxena ji, for thinking of me and giving me this huge platform. Much obliged to you.
It's our pleasure.
The two poems that are going to be read by me today are from my collection, What Trees Tell the Mortals and Other Songs. I will stick to the allotted time slot. The title of this poem is An Immigrant Dreams. The student from Punjab dreams of owning an outlet of Tim Hortons one day while working the counters on a cold day. Low wages, 40 hours a week, cash jobs, long commutes, the life of an immigrant in North America, especially Canada. The dreams, floating lamps, that illuminate the passage on a dark river back home. One day, she will own a house and a family, a bit of an alien sky, an immigrant continues to dream on. Thank you very much.
That was a very soul-touching poem, sir. You know, we could
In fact, very, you know, it speaks about the plight of so many immigrants all over the world.
Yes, yes. And
it's not only North America.
Of course, everywhere in the world. You know, they want to dream of having a better life and the struggles that they go through. Beautifully narrated, Sunil sir. Loved it. And yes, Rupa ma'am, dreamers, make them come alive or some dreams crash. So true, so true. It is either make or break for them. So with that beautiful poem, I would like to now invite Meenakshi ma'am to come forward, and she will be narrating her poem titled Gilhari. So welcome, Meenakshi ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And Dr. Sharma has already said so many good things about Neelam, so I don't have to add any more, except for I just want to thank her for being such a beautiful platform for the International Poetry Meet today. So thank you, Neelam. And thank you, Purna, for coordinating this event. I'm really honored in the company of such luminary poets and writers today. So it's a great honor for me. My first poem is called Gilhari, which means squirrel, or I think everybody knows it, concerta, it is squirrel. And I started my poem with a quote from Maya Angelou. She says, "In the silence, we listen to ourselves, and in the quieted, we may hear the voice of God," Maya Angelou. And here's my poem. "I watched the sinking sun from my deck, bereft of its glory, veiled behind the smoky clouds. Below on the ground, a fallen leaf fluttered, taking its last breath before dissolving into emptiness. Desolate and gloomy, the thought of pandemic, war, sickness, and death filled me with algebraic laments about the worthlessness of life. Then something caught my attention. A fuzzy brown gilhari with a long furry tail jumped up on the deck and stood below my chair, looking at me with his beady black eyes. Was he questioning my gloom, greeting me? Fascinated, I watched him. Soon he disappeared and appeared again, jubilantly running up and down the scaly bark of the oak tree. Captivated, I watched his agile, playful, bouncy movements, munching on the acorns, dancing under the sprinkles of the fountains, chasing after the chipmunks and hiding under the bushes. Enthralled by his playful frolicking, I forgot my solicitude and gloom. Up above, the Cimmerian clouds had dispersed. The orangish coral with cerulean hues adorned the western hemisphere. A soft, cold breeze tussled my hair. The sprawling branches of the oak danced with a rhythmic tempo, and the birds in a triangle were homebound. The sun, wrapped in tangerine glory, was leaving to come back. My gilhari, back on the deck, stood on his two legs with joined hands." Excuse me. Excuse me.
You can have some water.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, take your time.
"My gilhari, back on the deck, stood on his two legs with joined hands, looking up at the heavenly sphere. Was it a naman unto the Lord? Gratified, I shut my eyes in reference. Here art thou." These lines are for Rabindranath Tagore. "The divine creature, my gilhari, had disappeared, but I was at peace." Thank you.
That was wonderful, and I was reminded of Mahadevi Verma's story, Gillu.
Oh.
Very cute. Very, very cute poem, ma'am. Loved it.
Thank you so much. Sorry about my cough, you know, just...
That's fine. That's fine.
I'm a dusty house all day, so it is just getting to my throat, I think.
Yes. So, Rupa Rao can also see a gilhari outside her window. She is saying that I can see the squirrel. And she's enjoying the poem as well. Thank you, Deepa Agarwal, for joining. And thank you, Satbir ji, for joining. She is appreciating both Moon ji's poem and Meenakshi ji's poem. So, thank you, Satbir ma'am. So, with this, I would like to now invite Garima ma'am. And she will be reciting her poem titled, Should I Do It or Should I Not? I believe she is facing a battle inside her lovely mind. So over to you, Garima ji.
Thank you so much, Poorna. Namaste and salam to one and all. You all wonderful poets with whom I'm sharing this beautiful platform. And to all the listeners out there, thank you for joining. My humble gratitude to Neelam Saxena ji for giving me this lovely opportunity to be a part of this International English Poetry Meet. Title of my poem is, Should I Do It or Should I Not? I'm confused. Should I do it or should I not? Should I say it? Should I say it or keep it in my mind? Do I need to be patient as always? Or let my emotions flow. Many times I think about telling because mostly I stay silent. How many times should I stop myself? I ask myself this question. How many times I show proof of tolerance and keep increasing the hollow ego of the other person? Why do people do this? Why do people do this? They blame you without any mistake. How important is patience and understanding for everyone to know and follow? The incomplete words of others should be heard completely. Should I do it or should I not? Thank you so much.
That was a nice poem.
Yes, sir. We have Rupa Rao again telling you that you should definitely do it. She is stressing that you should definitely do it because it is going to give you a lot of satisfaction and positivity. So, thank you, ma'am. It was a very sweet poem. And next, I would like to invite Concetta from USA, New York. And she will be reciting her poem titled Seeking Truth in Poetry. And like the name suggests, it is themed on truth. A huge round of applause to Concetta.
Thank you, Perma. And it's a pleasure to be amongst so many esteemed poets and poetesses. I really don't know what I'm doing here, but... I guess I'll just recite Seeking Truth in Poetry. In shadows cast by ancient trees, we ponder, where do we come from? What origin story we conjure? Amidst whispers of winds and murmurs of streams, we seek truths hidden in fragmented dreams. Are we but echoes of stars in the night, birthed from cosmic dust, shimmering light, or fragments of clay molded by unseen hands, woven with threads from distant lands? What are we but seekers of understanding, lost in the labyrinth, endlessly teeming, towards heaven that beckons with tantalizing grace, yet tethered to earth in this mortal embrace. Are we vessels? Sorry. Are we vessels of thought, vessels of strife, crafting our destinies with each choice, with each life, or mere phantoms adrift in the void, seeking solace in stories, in myths long enjoyed? Where are we going in this grand cosmic drama? Through realms of existence in transient trance, to shores unknown where mysteries unfold, we journey seeking truths in tales yet untold. Thank you.
Wow, that was an amazing poem.
Yeah,
I'm glad you could make it despite the difficulties.
Thank you.
Really, it is very nice to hear you.
Yes. Thank you very much.
You're very talented and very, very brave, Gonsetta. Thank you.
Thank
for
you,
joining
us. Now,
thank you. Now, I would like to invite Neelam ma'am herself to recite her beautiful poem titled Death and Life, themed on organ donation. We are excited how Neelam ma'am brings a ray of hope in spite of such a dark theme. Over to you, Neelam ma'am.
Thank you, dear Purna. So it's my pleasure to be sitting with almost everyone known here and such talented poets. So here goes my poem, Death in Life. While she and I sat on a bench in a park one past evening, chatting with each other, our attention was distracted by the fall of a bird with a thud. We both ran in the direction, but we soon realized that it was no more. Seeing the state of shock that I was in, she held my hands tight and said, "Look, everyone has to go someday or the other." I boorishly stared at her and said, "Yes, I do know that, but I'm worried about something else." She gaped at me and asked, "And what is that?" I continued, "I'm anxious about the disposal of my body." She uttered candidly, "What about that? You were born a Hindu and your dead body will be placed on a pyre and burnt. If you so wish, your ashes can be spread over holy rivers and a pandit can chant hymns and mantras and..." Looking at my irritated eyes, she stopped her monologue and asked, "What do you exactly want?" I said, "What you said is something I utterly despise. Just imagine how wonderful will it be if I can see the world through someone else's gaze. If I could fall in love all over again. If I could cover some other body." She said in dismay, "I can't understand you." I said, "Let me solve the mystery for you. I wish to donate my eyes, my heart, my skin, and whatever else I can. And through the recipients, I'll get a new lease of life." She questioned, "And you think that your near and dear ones will allow your body to be shredded thus? What about the customs and traditions? What about the religion?" I said with a smile, "I'll neither be the first one nor the last one to do this. Someone has to take lead. Someone has to break the myths. And then I'll get a new lease of life. Imagine." My alter ego had no answers. she slowly started diminishing till she was no more. So that was my poem, Life and Death.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Such a passion you have brought. I am really happy. Mesmerizing. Such a passion you brought to the words, like a Hollywood actor. Great performance.
That's so nice of you. That's so nice of you.
The way you are acting out the moods, sentiments, words, everything.
Yes,
beautiful. Great performance, poetry. I would appreciate that. Sorry for intervention, but I couldn't help.
No. You have recited very beautifully, Neelamdi.
Yes.
Thank you.
Like in our childhood, we used to have one act plays. That scene came in front of me, like, you know, the way you have recited with all different
emotions,
tones of your verses. Beautiful.
It's a new avatar, I guess.
No, I have always loved acting, and it has been one of my passions.
I could guess it. So one of these days, we would love to host you for Setu, performing a short narrative poem.
Very sure. I would love it.
Thanks.
Amazing. Please give her a huge round of applause once again. It was amazing.
Thank you so much.
And, yes,
Santosh. So moving on further, Purna, it's my time. So the glee with which the butterflies move makes my soul happy and I soar. What can be more blissful to the divine? Can you ask for more? Let's hear Purna as she talks about these divine butterflies. Over to you, Purna.
Thank you so much, ma'am. That was a wonderful introduction. I would like to address my beloved favorite poet, William Wordsworth. It is a tribute to him. It's a nature-loving poem that I have tried to write, Butterflies. One fine day in summer paradise, I wandered alone, not thinking twice. Under the ultraviolet golden sun, wafer-like butterflies on the run. Hovering where the nectar rests, lies the prettiest of all insects. A miracle to feast my curious eyes, a caterpillar once seemingly dies, while another cocoon slowly breaks, a baby butterfly shrivels and shakes. Pollinating its way into the green, every plant says thanks in the scene. Dancing in a pretty polka-dotted grace, it runs until it is impossible to trace. For when I often go to the paradise, not heeding my dear mother's advice, I scan my eyes for that butterfly amongst the fluttering in the sky, wanting to capture it on reel, to behold whenever I feel. But butterflies can't be imprisoned away. Mother Nature makes sure of it every day. I think of a lens-free way to trap this glorious creature in a snap. I frame the butterfly in my head and I nail it to my mind instead. So no matter where I choose to unwind, butterflies are floating inside my mind. So that's my poem.
Beautiful.
Very beautiful. Very beautiful. As beautiful as you.
Thank you, ma'am. So, yes, that was Butterflies. And thank you, Arpita. Thank you, Deepa, ma'am. Thank you, Rupa, ma'am. Thank you, Santosh, ma'am. We move to round two of the International Poetry Meet. For all those lovely viewers who've just tuned in to the Neelam Saxena page, let us tell you that we've just completed round one and all these lovely poets from all different corners of the world are waiting to pour in their creations one more time. With that, I would like to now invite Meenakshi Mohan ma'am, and she will be reciting her poem titled On the Wings of Imagination, based on world peace, a subject that is very, very close to her heart. So welcome, Meenakshi ma'am, once more.
Thank you so much, Purna. Yes, peace is what I'm looking for these days. So the title of my poems is, as you said, On the Wings of Imagination. And I just want to give a little bit of background information on that poem. I wrote this poem when we spent the time on the coast of Penobscot Bay. I was mesmerized by its serenity and beauty. I could walk down to the beach with my three-year-old granddaughter and collect stones of all shapes and colors. When I look at these stones now, I realize they are no ordinary stones. They are cherished gems of beautiful memories. So here is my poem, On the Wings of Imagination. Whenever I visited 38 Shag Rock, I would wake up early hours in the morning, and with a cup of steaming Darjeeling in my hand, I would watch the grandiosity of the birth of the sun, spreading amber glory on the womb of the ocean. The broken wooden steps at some distance, half enveloped in the morning mist, descended to meet the sea, where the waves rolled versus on sands and rocks, and where the surrounding trees played the musical tempo. In the celestial solitude, I could hear nature vibrating, Shivoham, Shivoham, Shivoham. I would go down to the beach with my granddaughter to collect stones. With glee in her voice, she would come dancing to me and say, "Look, Ammu, this one's heart-shaped. Oh, this one has gold and silver stripes." And together we would collect stones of many shapes and colors. Time has fluttered by in its wings, but I still have those slaty blue, orangish colored stones. When I rub them in my palm, they work like talisman. The invisible engravings on them are like peace mantras. They take me away from my worries and stresses. I fly on the wings of imagination to the sandy beach of the coast with my granddaughter, and all I see is bliss around me. All I hear are the silent melodies of nature, mingled with my granddaughter's joyful, innocent laughter. I drown in the heavenly elixir of the moment, away from the world's clamor, and then nothing else matters. Thank you.
Oh wow, that was what Deepaji is saying, so evocative. Even the same words came in my mind while I was listening to your poem. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Very, very sweet. Veda would be tickled, because remembering her so much. Rupa Rao ma'am has just commented. And yes, sir, we are so happy that you actually brought out a topic which is the need for the hour right now, and that is world peace, something that everyone is concerned about. So lovely recitation, Meenakshi ma'am. I would like to now invite Pamsetta once more as she recites her poem titled Poetic Duties Call, and this poem is themed on duty. Welcome.
Mine are definitely not as enthusiastic as all of the others you have been reading, but a little bit more philosophy. Thank you for the introduction. In the silence of ink-stained night, poetry blooms, where shadows dance in the recesses of the mind. Each word a thread in the quilt of dreams, where meanings twist and turn undefined. Within the realm of verse, a journey unwinds through the alleys of symbol and signs, where the poet's hand wields both quill and sword navigating realms of truth, both dark and kind. Yet, in this realm of creation's boundless sea, lies the weight of responsibility, profound. For every syllable penned, every thought set free, shapes worlds unseen with echoes and resound. Oh, poet, hear the burden of your craft. As keeper of the sacred flame, embrace your role. For words have power to uplift or to daft, to heal the wounded heart or blacken the soul. In the crucible of language, forge anew the potent alchemy of truth and beauty's grace. With each stanza penned, a covenant to pursue the quest for meaning in this enigmatic space. Thank you.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Wow. Amazing. Amazing.
Thank you.
Very beautiful. Very beautiful. And yes, the words have the power to heal. They have the power to, you know, give us joy. They can also make us emotional. Words are very powerful. And your pen is also very powerful, Concetta. Thank you so
much. Thank you, Sharma.
With next, we are going to now invite Sunil Sharma, sir, all the way from Canada. And he will be reciting his poem titled Siren. And it is based on vulnerability. So over to you, Sunil, sir.
Thank you very much. Again, feeling very much inspired by the talent and the level of energy here, the kind of imagery being evoked,
yes.
Music, body language, everything so powerful and such a powerful platform. This 34th meet, my micro poem, Siren. Another landscape, Canadian. Here it goes. The siren, loud and clear. Then a squad car rushes on the distant highway. Somebody vulnerable, in need, unsettling on a snowy evening, desolate street, siren. Thank you very much once again.
Very nice.
Very nice. You know, this is an example of how you can write a powerful poetry in less words.
Yes. That's what I was about to say. Yes. Beautifully.
Yes. The landscape came alive. Yes, Rupa ma'am, it did come alive. That beautiful poem actually felt that all of us are in Canada with you. Micro magic. Yes, Santosh ma'am. Okay, so after that beautiful poem by Sunil sir, we have Neelam ma'am, and she will be reciting her poem titled Poetry. I cannot wait to hear this one, because this is one poem that all of us poets will be able to relate, because it talks about the power of poetry. So over to you, Neelam ma'am.
Thank you, dear Purna. You've already described the poem. So let me just begin directly. So my poem is titled Poetry. Here it goes. Dark eyes, afraid of tears, emotionlessly watch However, I'm poetry. I'm emotion itself. I helplessly watch. The railway station. People flooding from all directions, looking out for trains to go in random direction. Is the journey only to places? Or is it life's journey? I see a pair of wicked eyes looking for some child who's momentarily away from his parents. Those eyes, they wish to traffic a child for money. The chawl. People have been knowing each other since ages. Do they really? I see another pair of butchering eyes hunting for young girls to be put into brothels. Money is the only game. The bungalow in a famished village, full of luxuries. An old man is thrown out. He's been working there since he was a kid, desiring his freedom. As he sobs, he sees his youngest brother's son being brought in. Child labor. Who questions? Dark eyes, afraid of tears, emotionlessly watch. However, I am poetry. I am emotion itself. I helplessly watch. However, I raise questions which most don't bother to hear, but they do touch the heart of some well-wishers. A kind-hearted police woman is seen keeping an eye on the young kids every day. The brothels have been removed. Prostitution has not been completely eradicated, but it isn't rampant either. The village sarpanch is now a woman herself. During 2 tenures, she did what her husband wanted, but now she raises her voice, refuses to accept bonded labor. I'm poetry. I learned that I'm power. I learned that I'm power. I again start walking to help someone in pain. I'm poetry. Thank you.
Very nice.
Beautiful, beautiful, ma'am. Very unique poem, I would say. You know, because when I thought you're talking about poetry, I thought about the greatness of what poetry is. But you actually brought such a dark subject and you shed so much of light on it. And you ended up with so much of hope that with poetry, there is hope in this world.
Yes.
And poetry is the hope for the world. We can make the world a better place as poets. So very, very beautiful topic, ma'am. And yes, everyone is applauding you. Manjula ma'am, Rupa ma'am, Deepa ma'am, Arpita, thank you so much. So with that beautiful poem by Neelam ma'am, I would now like to invite Garima ma'am from Bahrain. And she will be reciting her poem titled, Who Am I? And she will be exploring her individuality as a woman. So over to you, Garima ma'am.
Thank you so much, Poorna. Thanks a lot. You're doing a wonderful job.
Thank you.
Title of my poem is, Who Am I? Who am I and what is my name? How much I'm connected to each and every one and what work I do? Why am I responsible for all these questions? Why am I responsible for all these questions? I must answer my own questions if there is a doubt in my mind. Since I am a woman, so do I have to fulfill all my responsibilities well? In every situation? In every condition? Who am I? Am I just a woman? Am I not a human being? Am I just a woman? Am I not a human being? I also breathe and feel pain. The irony is that in the collection of these questions, not only men, but also women stand against women. The irony here is that in the collection of these questions, not only men, but also women stand against women. What kind of society is this? And how about its rules and principles? You have also faced the same questions where you are standing against a woman. Who are you? And who am I? Understand and try to know this much, that we are made up of the same clay. Then what kind of discord or disharmony is this? Standing against each other, give sympathy. Give sympathy and support to each other. Who are you and who am I? Along with a woman, along with a woman's existence, I am also a human being like you two are. Thank you.
Wow.
Very well said. Very well said.
Powerful. Thank you so much.
Yes. And you recited it so well, Garima ma'am. We really were mesmerized by your recitation.
Thanks a lot.
So, I would like to say a few lines. Expectations grow like branches and rain and are the cause of all grief and pain. But how does one get rid of grief? Purna will give you a few mantras. Over to you, Purna.
What a beautiful way to start this wonderful poem. Thank you, ma'am. I couldn't have, you know, asked for a better introduction. With that, you know, beautiful introduction of Neelam ma'am on the five stages of grief, I will be narrating my poem. Grief comes in five stages. So I begin my poem. I shan't advise you not to weep, for not all your tears are evil. Let pass all the stages of grief. Take time to forgive the devil. I shan't advise you not to weep, for not all your tears are evil. Let pass all the stages of grief. Take time to forgive the devil. The very first stage is denial, when you refuse to believe the news. This stage is just but a trial for humans to feel their blues. The second stage has rage, for the devil caused this fate. Against yourself is a war to wage, for love gets conquered by hate. The second stage has rage, for the devil caused this fate. Against yourself is a war to wage, for love gets conquered by hate. Wars of thought lead to bargain, a stage natural to each one. Rational thoughts make you sane, and you realize it cannot be undone. The fourth stage can be very long. Depression is synonymous to sorrow. Can be overcome by the strong. They'll pray for a better tomorrow. The fourth stage can be very long. Depression is synonymous to sorrow. Can be overcome by the strong. They'll pray for a better tomorrow. The last stage of ours is to thank, for acceptance heals the pain. You will learn to forgive and be frank and live peacefully all the same. But beware if this stage turns sour and forgiveness doesn't change tables. I will advise you to weep once more, for not all your tears are evil. Beware if this stage turns sour and forgiveness doesn't change tables. I will advise you to weep once more, for not all your tears are evil. That's it with the five stages of grief. And we can be peaceful once again.
Wow, wow, wow. Wonderful, wonderful.
Thank you so much. You know, you've all been wonderful. Thank you, Rupa ma'am. Thank you, Arpita. Thank you, all the lovely poets who've, you know, recited their wonderful creations. We've had a very, very beautiful evening. And unfortunately, this evening is coming to an end. But I would like to thank all the wonderful poets who joined at different timings, you know, in their respective parts of the globe. Your poets really mean, your poetry means the world to us. And thank you, ma'am, for giving us the platform once more. You have been encouraging us, and you have been, you know, supporting us. So once again, a huge round of applause to Neelam ma'am. It's her page, and she has been wonderful as an admin throughout. And yes, viewers, it's always a pleasure to have you on board. You have been with us throughout this entire meet, and we cannot stop thanking you. Yes, Sunil sir, your book is well.
Congratulations to Neelam ma'am again.
Yes.
On the upcoming event. It's a collection of 50 Nazms in Hindi, and the title of her new collection is Parindo Sa Libas.
It's beautiful.
Mesmerizing, hypnotic poetry.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Congratulate her.
Yes.
And real honor to be here in extreme minority, but I learned a lot from all of you here.
The only gentleman.
The only gentleman.
A man, a gentleman, I don't know, but a man.
That we all know.
Yeah. It's a lot of bravery to come, you know, amidst so many women and narrate such beautiful poems. Thank you so much for joining.
I felt really inspired by all of you. Thank you again.
Thank
you.
Thank you, everyone. So we'll be seeing you next month with more poetry meets, same time, same place on the Neelam Saxena page on FB. Stay tuned. Good night and God bless. Thank you, everybody.
Good night. Thank you, everyone.
Good night.
Good night. Good night. Bye-bye.
Bye.